I freaking love these things. Have you seen them? It's these YouTube channels that stream music 24/7. So when I want to sit down for a study session, study some hacking, I'll turn on some chill hop. And it got me wondering, how do they do that? Because I kind of want to do it too. And think for a second about how cool that is. They have some sort of server or computer, and it's constantly sending a video stream 24/7 to YouTube. And they're not just doing a simple live stream where they turn on their camera and start talking. They have like files they're playing, a playlist of video files that cycle through, probably loop. And think about this. They're essentially creating their own TV channel, their own YouTube TV station that plays 24/7. And I thought, hey, I want to do that. I want my own chill hop station. I want my own YouTube TV channel. I want to play infomercials at 3 a.m. So I scoured the internet and I found a way to do this, and that's what I'm showing you in this video. I'm gonna walk you through how to set up your own YouTube TV channel, your own 24-hour live stream to play whatever you stinking want. Oh, yes, isn't that beautiful? And yeah, it's gonna be a bit nerdy, a bit geeky. I'm gonna show you how to do it in the cloud, and it's gonna be free thanks to our sponsor, Linode. They are my favorite cloud provider, and if you sign up right now, you get a $100 free credit to try whatever you want. So why not try to set up a 24/7 YouTube live stream? And if you don't care about the cloud, I'll show you how to set it up on-prem or in your house as well. Now, what do you need for this project? Well, first, you'll need a Linux computer or server that's running Ubuntu 18.04. And if you're like, man, I don't have a server or a computer, don't worry. I'll walk you through how to set up a server in the cloud for free, thanks to our sponsor, Linode. And this is so easy to do. You'll be up and running in about 5 minutes, or you can also put this on-prem in your house on a server or computer you already have. I'll walk you through both. Now, this next thing's probably pretty obvious. You'll need a YouTube channel, and a YouTube channel that can do live streaming, which right now there's pretty much no requirements to enable live streaming. You just have to say enable. I'll put a link below so you can figure out how to do that. And also, it doesn't have to be a YouTube channel. It can be Facebook, it can be Twitch, LinkedIn, or Twitter, whatever place that can receive a video stream you can do this on. But to keep things brief, I'm just gonna cover YouTube. And then another obvious one, you'll need something that you can play, some kind of video file. It could be your home movies. You can create your own Truman Show. It can be a video with music playing. It'd be whatever you want, but you'll need some sort of video files to actually play. And then last but certainly not least, the most important thing you'll need is coffee, because you can't do anything in tech. In IT, without coffee, never chuck dot coffee. All right, we have what we need. Time to set this up. And by the way, I've already set mine up because you're watching this video after I've done it, so you can check it out right here. It should be live streaming right now, so if you think that's pretty cool, let's create your own. Step one, let's get our server set up, and we'll start with our cloud one here in Linode. Get that $100 free credit if you go to linode.com/networkchuck. And once you're signed up and signed in, we're gonna click on create at the top left, and we're gonna create a Linode. And here's where things get stupid simple and frankly kind of awesome. We're gonna click on marketplace. And this is so cool because instead of building our own server and installing the application ourselves, it's already here. We just click it and it works. Now, the application we're looking for is a software called Ant Media or Ant Media Server. This thing's pretty cool. I'll show you why, but let's go ahead and build it out. So we're gonna scroll down just a tad right here, and there it is, Ant Media Server. Click on that. And once you have that selected, we'll scroll down and put in some info about the server. Like, what region do we want this in? For me, I'm just gonna choose something close to me. And then how big do we want the server? I always like to do a shared CPU. It costs less. And we'll go for the cheapest option, and a node 1 gigabyte. And this will cost you $5 a month, but you're getting it for free if you have that $100 free credit. And then we'll scroll down just a bit more and name our machine here. I'll name it My TV Channel. It can be whatever you wanna name it. And then I'll put in a password. And that's pretty much it. I'm gonna click on Create Linode and let the magic happen. Perfect time for a little coffee break. So we'll sit here and wait just for a moment while it's provisioning. Shouldn't take very long. And then you'll know things are done when you see that it's running. Now, with these one-click apps, keep in mind that the server is booted, but currently right now they're running some scripts to install Ant Media. So I would give it about 5 minutes before we try to access some things. So again, what's wrong with more coffee? Let's go ahead and take a little coffee break and jump forward in time.
Later.
All right, once you've waited about 5 minutes, we'll go ahead and take this IP address right here. Just click on that little clipboard to copy it. They'll open up a new tab, paste that in the URL field bar. I don't know why I struggle saying that. And then do a colon and specify the port 5080 or 5080 and hit enter. Oh, look at this. Installed and ready to go. First, we'll set up our account, put in your full name, username, password, and click on create account. And now we can log in with that stuff we just created. Let's go. Look at that. Like, probably the easiest installation of anything ever, right? That was awesome. Now let's get your live stream set up. And this is probably even easier than the last part. Let's try it out. Now, before we continue, make sure you have your video files that you want to stream. So if you don't have them yet, go ahead and create them. I'm going to make mine right now, actually. It'll be chill hop music. That is pretty much the music I play on my channel all the time. So if you like my music, that's what my station is going to be doing. So I'm gonna do it real quick. All right, got my video ready. Now time to go into Ant Media and set up our live TV station, our 24/7 YouTube live stream. The first thing we'll do is under applications, we're gonna click on live app. Click on that sucker, there we go. And then on the right, click on new live stream. And here we'll have some options because Ant Media is a beast. It's so cool. But the thing we want to do right now is select playlist, because we're going to play a playlist of videos we already have. Name this whatever, I'll name it my channel. And that's pretty much all we need. We can click on create and it's done. Well, not quite done. It's created, but we still have to add some stuff to it to make it work. The first thing is obvious. We need to add a video file to this server so we can stream it. To do that, we'll go up here to the top and click on VOD or video on demand. It's gonna change our menu for us, boom. And this is where we'll add our individual video files. So go ahead and click on upload to upload your video file, upload VOD, and go find your file. Choose your file and look in your file system for it. I'll go find mine, there she is, and save. It's gonna upload and do its thing. Give it time, perfect time for a, well, yeah. And mine is uploaded, all right, click okay. Now we're gonna stay here for a second, we gotta do one thing. First, I want you to go up here and grab your IP address, the IP address of your server, and also the port. So IP address and then colon 5080. And paste that into a notepad, and then we'll add one more thing after the 5080. We'll do a forward slash, I almost said backslash, live app, and it's getting too big, let me make it small. There we go, forward slash live app, forward slash streams, and then forward slash the video ID of the video you just uploaded. Well, where do you get that? Let me show you real quick. Get back to Ant Media. You see this right here? Right underneath your file, you have your VOD ID. That's what we need, that long string of numbers. I almost lost my voice. Let's go ahead and grab that and copy it. Go back to your notepad or wherever you're using, paste that right after streams, and then at the end of that string, do .mp4. I would also make sure that your live app is capital L and capital A for app. It is case sensitive. So it should look just like this. If yours looks like that, you're good to go. Time for the next step. Let's get back to Ant Media. We're gonna slide on over back to our live stream section up here. And then we'll click on the pencil icon to edit our live stream. We'll name our playlist, my playlist, can be anything. Then we'll click on add playlist item. And here's where we'll paste in our URL that we just made. Right there, and click on save. You should get a little save icon at the top saying playlist is updated. Now we're almost done. We created our server, we created our live stream, we added a video to it. Now all we need is a place to stream that too, which for our example, in our case, will be a YouTube channel. So let me go to youtube.com real quick. You ever heard of it? And if you have live streaming enabled, all we have to do is click on the camera up here at the top with the plus sign, click on that, and click on go live. Now don't worry, nothing crazy gonna happen just yet. It's gonna take you to the live stream portal, your studio, and here we are. Now this might look like a lot going on here. Don't worry, I'll walk you through it. First, let's change what our live stream is gonna be about. So my title, nothing here, I'm gonna change that. Click on edit, name it Network Chuck TV channel. Add a description, I'll do that later. Visibility, now this is key. If you wanna throw caution to the wind and go public right away, go for it. But that will be public. For me, I like to test things, so I'll make it unlisted for now, or even private, but unlisted's good. That way no one can see it but me for now, unless I give them the link. You can also add your own thumbnail, which I already have right here, and a bunch of other YouTube customizations. You can check that out yourself or look it up. I'll go ahead and click on save. And now we only need two things from our YouTube studio. First, we'll need this, my pen, come back. Okay, first we'll need this stream URL, and we'll also need our stream key. Notice how mine is dotted out so you can't see it, because it's something you want to keep secure. If someone has your stream key, they can stream to your YouTube channel, so don't show that to anybody. So let's go ahead and grab our stream URL, just click on copy, and I'll go back to my notepad and paste it in here. And then I'll go back to YouTube, and I'll copy my stream key, which I'll show you mine right now. I can reset it, so don't worry, you're not gonna be able to stream to my stuff. So I'll show it to you, there's what it looks like. I'll click on copy to copy that, and then over here on my URL, I'll just do a forward slash at the end of live 2 and paste that stream key there. Then we'll go ahead and grab this entire URL beginning with RTMT. I'm fighting the urge to explain what RTMT is. I'll go ahead and tell you just a little bit. I'm gonna do it. RTMT is a networking protocol for streaming video. It stands for real-time messaging protocol. It uses TCP for a persistent connection. Sorry, I'm getting kind of nerdy here. I have to tell you, I can't help it. And it has low latency, which is what you want for anything you're gonna be using for real time, which is streaming. Live streaming. So anyways, nerd time over. Let's copy that URL, go back to Ant Media, and instead of clicking on the pencil icon, we're gonna click on the hamburger menu over here on the right. And from here, we'll select Edit RTMT Endpoints. That's a mouthful, click on that. And right here in this open space, we're gonna paste in our RTMT URL and click on Add. Done, it's there. You'll get a little icon at the top that says, hey, you added it successfully. Now, at this point, we're ready. Are you ready for this? Okay, here we go. So just like a magician, I'm gonna show you what it looks like now. So right now, if I go to YouTube, look, no stream, nothing's happening. But if I go over here to Ant Media, the server we just created out of thin air in the cloud, we're gonna click on our hamburger icon again once more. And then we'll click on Start Broadcast. Are you ready for this? And go. Oh, stream starting. Please wait a few seconds. Okay, so it's broadcasting down here. Status, broadcasting 0.94, whatever. Let's go to YouTube. Okay, it's working. Oh. Oh, yes. Isn't that beautiful? Dude, I'm live streaming from a server in the cloud. It's playing a file I made, and that sucker can be up 24/7. And in case you're wondering, yes, that file will loop. Once it's done, it'll start over. You don't have to just stream to YouTube like I mentioned before. You can stream to your own website if you want to have your own live stream. I can click this play icon right here and just open up a window and verify that it's playing or working. There it is. I can go over here and click my hamburger icon again. I can copy the embed code and embed that in my website. Oh my gosh, so cool. Now real quick, I do want to take a moment and brag on Ant Media Server. This product is free. I mean, right now we're using the Community Edition and we're able to create a live stream and stream to YouTube 24/7. How cool is that? And it's not just that we're streaming to YouTube, it's that we created our own private in-house live streaming solution. So if you're a business that doesn't want to expose your live stream to the public, put this on one of your servers and stream to your people on your intranet website. It's free. Now, if you need more horsepower or lower latency, they do have an enterprise edition. If you look at what they have in that, you do go from 8 to 12 seconds of latency to 0.5 seconds, which latency is how quickly your video can get to someone else. So if you need that real time interaction, that's where it comes in. But anyways, I know this is kind of a weird video because I'm talking about creating a live stream, but I thought this was cool. The tech is cool and it's something I wanted to do, and it's something you can do too if you just want to try something fun. And for real, right now, go watch my stream. It'll be on 24/7. If you want to study and chill out with other people in the chat, you can. Now, we spent most of our time in the cloud and how to set this up in Linode for free, but what if you want to install this in your house, on your own server, in your business? Here's how to do it real quick. And of course, this does involve you having your own server, your own hypervisor or something. If you don't know what that is, like what is a server, what's a hypervisor? I've got videos you can follow right up here. Check them out. Anyways, I'm using Proxmox for my example, and I already deployed a Ubuntu 18.04 server or Linux virtual machine. But I don't want to hang out here on the console, so I'm going to log in or SSH into it via my terminal here. I'll do a quick sudo apt update to update my repositories. Then I'll jump into the Ant Media GitHub, scroll down just a bit to find the release file. Should be right here, should be a zip file. I'll just right click that and copy the link address. Get back to my terminal and I'll type in wget to go get it, to download it. Paste in that URL, it's downloading it, I think. Yes, there it goes. And then I'll use wget once more to download the installation script, which you can copy and paste from below to save yourself some time. Hit enter and then time to run that installation script. We'll do sudo ./ install at. Again, copy and paste if you want to. Sometimes I just like to type stuff in, it feels good. We'll do a -i, and we'll specify the name of that file, which is right up here, that we downloaded, the zip file. Just grab that sucker, paste it right after that, and that's it. Hit enter, and away it goes. Little coffee break. And it's done. Ant Media Server is installed and started, but let's make sure it's not lying to us. Let's verify that. We can do a systemctl ant media status. We get that backwards. Systemctl status ant media active and running. What I want to see. Perfect. Just hit Q to end that. And now let's grab the IP address of our server, which let me just see IP address. You should already know yours. Mine's right here. I'll open up my web browser, paste in that IP address. Oh wait, I did not grab it. I'll just type it in. And the port 5080. And there she is. Now at this point, this is just like the cloud installation. So to learn how to go through this, set it up, set up the live stream and send that sucker to YouTube, go back and follow that tutorial because it's pretty much the dang same and I don't like repeating myself. Anyways, that's about it guys. Let me know what you think of making a YouTube TV channel, kind of like a 24/7 live stream. I've always wanted to do this and now I've done it and you can do it too. And also feel free to put your video link in the comments below of your live stream running. How cool would that be just to have a bunch of live streams going? We're gonna blow up YouTube. And speaking of blowing up YouTube, make sure you hack them today too. Hack the algorithm. Hit that like button, notification bell, comment, subscribe. Let's hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. Now, I will also have a walkthrough of everything we did in this video, so if you prefer to follow a checklist, a thing, a document, why couldn't I think of the word document? A document to figure out how to do this. Got that too, link below. Oh, and again, thanks to Linode for sponsoring this video. If you don't use Linode for anything, what you been doing? I use Linode for everything. You saw the amount of Linodes I had running in my dashboard? It's ridiculous. I use too much, but I love them so much. Anyways, later. Oh, why are you still here? You should be watching my live stream. It's 24/7, go study. Chill hop it up, man. Why are you still here? Go. Stop wasting time. You should be studying right now. Yeah, I'm done for real. I'll talk to you guys later.